Welcome to this React Diagram tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to create a mind map using the Syncfusion React Diagram component. You will also see how to customize the nodes and connectors, modify layout spacing, add expand and collapse icons, and change the orientation of the diagram. I will recreate this mind map shown using automatic layout and data manager utilities. First, let me open my React application, where I have added the Syncfusion diagram component with basic properties. To learn how to add a diagram component to a React application, follow the link on the card above and in the description below. Let me run the application using the npm start command and show the initial output. You can see the empty diagram canvas rendered. Now, to create a mind map diagram, I need to define a data source. So, I create a JS file named data. Within it, define an exported array of objects named mind map data, and paste the data which I copied from the J2 diagrams documentation page. It contains the properties ID, label, parent ID, and branch. Each object in this array will be rendered as a node. The ID property acts as a unique identifier for each node. The value in the label property will be displayed as the node's annotation. The parent ID property establishes parent-child relationship between the nodes, and the branch property denotes the position of the nodes in the layout. Next, I navigate back to the app.tsx file and import the mind map data variable from the data.js file. To bind data to the diagram component, I need to pass the data to the data manager utility. The data manager acts as the gateway for local and remote data sources, using queries to interact with the data source. I create a data manager variable and pass the mind map data inside the constructor. To use this data manager, let me import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. Then, in the diagram component tag, I add the data source settings property and assign an object. Inside this object, set three properties, ID to ID to handle the current node ID, parent ID to parent ID to denote the source node in a connection, thus indicating the diagram flow, and data manager to the data manager variable. Next, I import the data binding and mind map modules from the EJ2 React Diagrams package. The data binding module generates diagrams from an external data source, while the mind map module arranges nodes around the central node. Let me inject these two services into the diagram component. In the diagram canvas, you can now see the nodes rendered, but not in the desired manner. Next, let me show you how to use the layout property to automatically arrange nodes in the diagram canvas. Let me create a layout variable of type layout model. I import the layout model interface from the EJ2 React Diagrams package and set the properties type with the value mind map and orientation with the value horizontal. You can also use the vertical orientation property to align your mind map vertically. Inside the diagram component, I add the layout property and assign the layout variable. The diagram is arranged automatically based on the ID and parent ID properties. Next, I will show you the necessary changes required to style the nodes and connectors. I add the getNodeDefaults property in the diagram component and bind a method name. Then I define the getNodeDefaults method, which takes the node model type as parameter. I import the node model interface from the EJ2 React Diagrams package. Within this method, set the node's annotations with an array of objects. Inside, define the content property and set the noDateIsLabel property. I return the node object in the end. You can now see the nodes are rendered with annotations. To modify the mind map's visual appeal, I plan to change the shape, height, width, and color of the node. Let me set the node's height to 40 pixels and width to 110 pixels. I create a branch variable and store the branch type from the node data. Using this variable, I can check whether the node is a root node or a subright node, denoting the position in the mind map. Now add an if condition to check whether the branch is root. Then change the default rectangle shape by setting the node shape type to path. Add the data property and assign the custom shape path value. Also, I customize the node style by setting the fill color and setting the stroke width to 0. In the same if condition, I check if the node's branch is left or right to modify its shape and colors. Within the shape property, check if the branch is not root and set its type to basic and shape to ellipse. This will set the ellipse shape only to the left and right. Using the same procedure, I assign a different style if the branch is not root. In the else condition, for the rest of the nodes, I set a different fill color and stroke width to 0. I also set the font color for the annotations to white. Now you can see the mind map rendered with multiple colors. To differentiate the nodes on the left side of the mind map from those on the right, I will modify their color. Inside this style property, I check if the branch type is subright and set a different color. The nodes on the right are now rendered with a separate color. Next, I will modify the connectors by changing the type and style. Let me add the get connector defaults property and bind a method name. I define the get connector defaults method, which takes the connector model type as parameter. I also add an optional parameter diagram, which contains the current instance of the diagram component. To use the connector model interface, let me import it from the J2 React Diagrams package. I start by setting the connector type to Bezier and remove the target decorator by setting the decorator shape to none. Then I edit the connector style and set the stroke width to 3 pixels. I return the connector at the end of the method. You can now see the connectors are rendered as per our modifications. I need the source and target nodes to set the connector properties based on their position. So I define a source node variable, and using the diagram parameter, I invoke the getObject method and pass the source ID from the connector object. I do the same after creating the target node variable, but using the target ID instead. Then I create a branch object and assign the branch property from the target node data. To set separate styles for the right and left connectors, I add an if block and check whether the branch is left or subleft. Within it, edit the connector style and set a stroke color. Next, I add another if condition to check if the branch is right or subright, and add the stroke color. In the diagram canvas, notice the connectors are colored as per the defined styles, but they are connected on random places. To change that, I'll add ports to the nodes, ensuring the connectors are connected through them. So, inside the getNodeDefaults method, I add ports and assign an array of objects. Then define two ports inside. To learn more about diagram ports, check out the React Diagram Ports video linked in the description below. Next, I need to connect the nodes using the ports. So, for the left and sub-left connectors, I set the source port ID with the source node's first port ID by passing the index 0. Then I set the target port ID with the target node's second port ID. Similarly, I modify the right and sub-right connectors as well. Notice that I have inverted the port IDs to connect in the opposite direction. Now the connectors are connected through ports as per the customization. Notice that the mind map is arranged with a default spacing, but I can increase or decrease that by changing the layout property. In the layout variable, I set the vertical spacing and horizontal spacing properties to 50 pixels. The spacing is reflected on the diagram canvas. Next, I'll show you how to enable the expand and collapse icons in the nodes to expand and collapse the mind map. Inside the getNodeDefaults method, add the expand icon and collapse icon properties. Then set the expand icon shape to minus and collapse icon shape to plus. Now you can expand or collapse any diagram flow by clicking the icons. Finally, I'll demonstrate the orientation change in the mind map diagram. In the layout variable, let me change the orientation to vertical. To maintain proper visibility, I reduce the horizontal spacing value. Additionally, I alternate the X and Y values in the node ports. Now you can see the mind map rendered vertically. Let me summarize. I showed you how to create a mind map using the Syncfusion React Diagram component. I also showed you how to customize connectors and nodes by using the default methods and use expand and collapse options in the mind map. You can download the example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also added a link in the description to check whether you qualify for our license key so you can use our React products through our community license. If you found this video useful, drop a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.